zero hour, you have become already half of the engineers. So a very important subject of final year, that is BCS department, is modern database system. In short, it is also called as MDS. So today we are going to start the first chapter of this subject. Now before going to start the actual content of the subject, I will just give you an overview of what this subject is all about. So modern database system, as the name suggests, we have database system. Now what is database? Database is collection of data. Collection of data. And what is data? Data is information. Any information you collect is called as a database. And we gather a lot of data, then it becomes a database. So nowadays, or whatever may be the thing you do, or in any of the area, you collect the data, and that database is very important. So you keep the data in the computer system. Earlier it is kept in the files, that is physical storage. But when the computer invent, when the storage system invent, when the memory comes, you are going to store the data in the form of files, and those files are stored in the computer system. That's why that is called as a database. Now, database management system. Database management system is the system which manages the database. So, in short, it is also called as a DBMS. So, there are lots of softwares are available, there are lots of systems are available which are used to implement or which are used to handle your database, and that software or the systems is called as a database management system. So you can have many such type of system, that is called as MySQL is there, Oracle is there, DB2 is there. So there are lots of systems are available, software systems are available which handle your database. Now handling the database means what? Not only storing the database but also perform the different operations on that database. The different operations like insertion, deletion, updation of the database. Likewise, handling your database so that it should be in correct format whenever you want to use that database. So this is overall about what is database management system. Now we move on to our subject, that is modern database system. It is the extension of, you can think of, the database management system. Now actual modern database system consists of, the subject consists of 8 chapters or 8 units. Section 1 consists of 4 units and section 2 consists of 4 units. Now section 1 explains you how the database is handled in more modern way, in more secure way, what are the different architectures which are used to handle the database. Next we move on to query processing. Now what is query processing means? You store the database and if you want to perform some operations on that database, you fire some query, you give some commands to the computer system, and in return to the command, the computer system will give you the result. So that is called as a query. It is a technical word which you use for the processing of the data. Now it is also called as a SQL language. You might have been already known about the SQL language, already you have well aware of the SQL languages. So query processing is there, now the query optimization, how the query can be optimized, how the query can be evaluated. That is the second part. The next one and important part is front additional database, that is from DBMS. Traditional database, that is database management system, we move on to big data. So from unit 1 to unit 8, the last chapter consists of the introduction about the big data. Big data, as you might aware of, the current database, the current database of this system. So we have started with data, we have started with database, then we move on to modern database, and then we conclude with the last chapter, that is called as a big data. In today's world, whatever see all about the big data and how to handle that big data. That is the technology required to handle that big data, and the most important technology is called as Hadoop, which is the most current, you can say the current area of handling the big data in today's IT world. So big data is also very important, but before that, you should know about the basics of what is the database system. Now we are going to actually start the first chapter, and the unit one is database system architecture. This is your first unit of the subject modern database system. Now, what is architecture? Architecture is nothing but the schema or the design or the overall structure of any of the system. Now, we are talking about the database architecture. That is how the database is maintained inside the system. Now, database system architecture is mainly dependent upon the three things. The first thing is networking. The second is parallelism, and the third one is distributed. These are the three basic things on which any architecture of any database system depends on. Now, one by one, we are going to see each of these three bits. The first one is networking. Networking is what? Networking is nothing but interconnection of many components which are interconnected with each other. So I will show you a sample diagram of a computer network. You can see there are different computers and they are interconnected with each other through a network. So this is called as a network. There are so many types of network. Computer networks are available, for example, LAN, WAN, MAN. So there are lots of networking under. We are not going to go in depth of the networking. We are just going to see what are the basics which define any of the database system architecture. So networking is the first base of any of the database architecture. So you can see networking is nothing but just connection of a computer with the help of networks. Now this network may contain routers. This network may contain gateways. Connect computer with one another. So this is about the networking. Now parallelism. Parallelism means what? How your operation is performed inside the computer system. Now one example I will give you of this. Suppose we are having one task. Now this is a 5-minute task. 5-minute processing. There is a job. One task is there and it requires a 5-minute of processing. Now this task, of course, you will do through a processor. So this processor will take 5 minutes to complete that task. Now suppose I want to faster this processing. I want to perform the processing in a faster way so that my output should come in a minimum time. Now what I can do is, instead of a single processor, you can divide the task on multiple processors. Now, how this is done? This is the 5-minute processing. That is the same task. Now, it can be divided to 5 processors. I will give the name as P1, P2, P3, P4, and P5. So 5 processor will take the task, and every processor will take 1 minute to perform that processing. So this is 1 minute, this 1 minute, P2, this is 1 minute, this 1 minute, and last one take 1 minute. So as you can compare, this figure
single processor into multiple processor, as you can see P1 to P5, that task can be completed within 1 minute as compared to 5 minutes. So this is called as a parallelism. You are fastening the process by dividing the task into multiple tasks, and that task is simultaneously handled by multiple processors. So this is a very important concept in case of database system. Why it is important? Because database consists of many transactions, many database operations, and that database operation should be performed in minimum time. So to perform in minimum time, we can have multiple processors work simultaneously at the same time. So instead of overtime, you can get the same output in minimum time. So that is the parallelism. Now we move on to distributed. As the name suggests, distributed means what? You are dividing, you are distributing the data. Now I will show you one example of this. Suppose this is here. The next bit we are going to see in the next video.